Hello, everybody. Welcome to Elite Wine TV. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Elite Wine TV. I'm your host, Mark Fusco, here for another edition of the show. Where am I on? There we go. Anyway, hello. We have yet another wine from Underground Cellars this week. This is the 2005 Il Podere del Olivos, and this is not an Italian wine, but it's just got an Italian name to it. Teroldego, which is an Italian grape, for $25 on Underground Cellar. So this is one of those, I'm going to call it a mystery wine, but it was a wine that, the problem is I used to be able to find this stuff on Underground Cellar again after I bought it, but I was having a hard time today finding some of these wines I purchased a year or two ago. Anyway, so this is from a winemaker by the name of Jim Clendenin. That's going to be just a little rinse. Sorry, I use a little vainerism. Anyway, who is also the, quote, mind behind. That's what it actually says it on here, too. Au Bon Climat Winery, which I think he said translates to the good vineyard. That winery specializes in Chardonnay, Pinot Noir, Pinot Blanc, Pinot Gris. This wine is one of his little side projects he has. So he has other little side projects from different types of grapes throughout California. It's a California winery. There we go. Got all kinds of red juice on there. And got it from Underground Cellar. It seems like this is the only vintage for this wine. So it might have been just he got some Teroldego grapes, wanted to experiment with it for 1 year, and then said, okay, I'm done. So who knows how good the wine is. Maybe he liked it and didn't want to do it again. I don't know. He's been in the business for a very long time. He traveled around the world a little bit to he was in Europe when he turned 21, decided he didn't want to go to law school. You know, it's happened to a lot of these guys from the 70s and 80s. They went to college, was going to go to law school, decided to take a year off or a few months off, go travel Europe and go, oh, I want to do wine instead. And they did, instead of like they tried it and failed and went to work for the man. This guy, you know, said, hey, I'm going to do this. All right, Teroldego is an Italian grape. It's mainly from the northeast part of Italy, the Trentino Alto Adige Sudatrol part, it's sometimes compared to Zinfandel by California producers, though it's not the same flavor profile, but there's a similarity to it, at least from what the Americans think. All right, so let's get into, and this is the second or third time I've had this grape variety on the show. All right, so let's start again with the grid. All right, this wine is a red wine. No evidence of any gas or sediment in it. It is mostly opaque. It's not clear at all. It is, I don't know, I wouldn't call it bright. I mean, it does reflect the light, but I'd call it somewhat dull. It is definitely an intense, deep red color with a very little bit of rim variation. There is some slight staining on the glass. Viscosity is low. On the nose, I do not see any evidence of faults. It is clean, but it is funky. It is of moderate intensity, has a bit of funk to it. I wouldn't necessarily call this Brettanomyces. That's why I don't think it's faulted or considered faulted. But there is a bit, I don't know, if I say there's no Brett, I can't say there's Barnyard. One man's Brett is another man's Barnyard. So, there's an earthiness to it. Wet earth. Wet soil. Potting soil. Savoriness to it. Smoked meat. I don't get any fruit. Very little wood actual aroma, though there is some spices, some cooking spices to it, which could lead to just, it's oak, but I don't know what kind of oak. Nothing jumps out. I don't smell any coconut, so therefore I will gauge that this is mostly French oak. This wine is dry. Tannins are medium. Acid is, I'll call it medium plus in the acid. Alcohol is medium. It is a moderate, medium bodied. Go medium plus on the tannin. It's starting to grip a little more. Medium bodied wine. I don't really get any fruit again. Palate and the nose. Are similar. There's a bit of bitterness to it. Tartness, sourness. Not really a sour fruit necessarily, but there's a, it could be the acid causing me to pucker up. So acid, I'm not gonna call acid high because my mouth is watering. I'm very puckered up. I mean, I only got 17 seconds. I wouldn't guess this at all. This is not a guessable wine. But I would probably put it in the Syrah camp versus a Zinfandel camp. And I probably would call it New World. I know there's no fruit to tell me anything, but there's a kind of... there isn't an elegance that you get with the earthiness from the wine that you get from the Old World. It's more of an in-your-face intensity that New World gives you. I mean, it's $25 red wine. This is a wine that, on its own, I'm like, it's all right. I can tell you this much, and I skipped over that. So I didn't give you an age assessment on the nose, but I wouldn't necessarily say this is a youthful wine. I might say it has some age to it, but I would never guess it's 10-ish years old, especially on the color. It's pretty deep color. It doesn't look like it's starting to get brown or orange. I would definitely not put this... If I was going to say it had some age, I'd say maybe 3 to 5 years, but I wouldn't say it would, I would definitely not say it's 10 plus years. So I would totally fail on that. Not fail, but I wouldn't get that part. I mean, it's not a wine that I'm necessarily saying is great. However, if you like those, you know what? It's kind of an, all right. So the name of the wine is the Olive Farm. And there is a bit of that olive, more like green olive, not black olive. And I don't like green olive. I love black olive, though. But yeah, there is a bit of that green olive. Yeah. A bit of that green olive-ness. If you like that type of stuff, this is probably a wine you like. $25 if you can find it. Like I said, I didn't see any other on the internet. A couple of the sites that mention this wine, they're all 2005 from what I remember. So this might have been a one and done. He might not have been happy with the result. He might have been like, ah, I tried it. I'm not going to do it again. It's not a bad wine. It's not a great wine. You know, maybe he, who knows? Or something else shiny came along and he wanted to try it. It's okay. If you like those types of wines, so while I said that the California producers, that's what Wikipedia said, the book of knowledge, if you will, said that it was a California producers, had to say it's similar to Zinfandel. I'd say it's kind of similar to Syrah, if anything else. So if I was going to guess this on a blind, I probably would go, I think this is a Syrah from like a non-standard part of the world. You know, maybe New Zealand or whatever, you know, I don't know. But I would have picked it being something probably closer to that then, because I would, like I said, this may be like the, I don't know about the show, maybe one other time, but this is maybe the second or third time I've ever had this grape. So, not bad. But I'm not rushing out to buy another bottle. You know, once I put some food with it, hopefully it'll taste really good. But since it's a Corvin wine, I can wait until I find the right time to try this wine with food. All right, so that's going to do it for this episode. I never started the stopwatch, did I? Nope, sure didn't. That's going to do it for this episode. As always, thank you for stopping by. Check the link below for Aubonne Climat Winery, because this project he doesn't have a website for, or really he has any of his other ones. So check out this guy over there and his wines he's got. Hopefully those wines, if I ever have them, are a little bit more my style. And then leave comments below. Hit the donate button over here to send me some ducats to buy some more $25 Terroldegos or some other different varietal, like a little bit of ferment from Hungary, some dry ferment for $19 at Central Market that I almost bought today. But I bought the Groovy, only the Groovy from, you know, a few episodes ago. Let's see. Click the links above to friend me up and tell your friends about it. Leave me a 5-star rating on iTunes. And that's going to do it. We'll see everyone again next time.